Hi everybody, it is Carla the Bubble Lush, and I wanted to do an update on breastfeeding now that Hannah is 6 weeks old. So, Hannah's going to join me. She just ate and farted, so she is good to go. Keeping it real, Hannah. Okay. So, you're hilarious. Let me get this pillow. I'm going to sit on the pillow so you're a little higher. Oh, that's much better. Okay, so the last time I talked to you guys about breastfeeding, I think she was 2 weeks old, and we were having a really hard time with it. And luckily, right after 2 weeks, things started getting easier. We went to the lactation consultant and perfected her latch. I was just having, what she would do is she would get so frantic that she would open her mouth and close it really fast. So she'd be like, mom, 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 mom. And she wouldn't hold it open long enough for me to like shove my boob in there. And so it wasn't getting deep enough in her mouth, and she was basically just gnawing on my nipple. So it hurt really bad. Once her and I worked together to both get my breast farther into her mouth, and it felt awful, but really holding the back of her head and just holding her right up on my boob, everything started getting a lot better. Basically, I guess she just wasn't strong enough to keep it in her mouth, so I had to hold her onto my boob. And once I did that, she was great. So, really, if you're having problems with breastfeeding, I definitely suggest talking to a lactation consultant. I mean, think of it, their entire job is breastfeeding. It's crazy. So they know what they're talking about. So you definitely use that resource. They have them at, you know, most hospitals, so call them up and see if anyone can help you. And they're great. One thing I found, though, is since we had so many problems and my nipples were such a hot mess at the beginning, here I thought breastfeeding was going to be this really cheap option. Besides just being wonderful for her, it was going to be really cheap, and it has not been. So I wanted to go over some of the products I used and, you know, kind of tell you when they were useful, if I'm still using them, if they were a good investment or not. One of the first things I bought was, once I realized that I was just going to have a lot of stuff. Here I thought breastfeeding was just going to be the baby and my boob. No, there is a lot of stuff involved, so at least there was in the beginning. So what I did was I went to Target and I wanted to buy a caddy, like the kind you use to keep cleaning supplies in. But they didn't have anything that really fit what I was talking about, and this was the only option. So it looks like this. It's by Michael Graves, I think. It was at Target. Inside, it's got this round portion, and this is to hold a paper towel, and then this is all open all the way around. It's got a great handle, it's pretty big, and this stayed on my nightstand and is still on my nightstand to this day. This small section where the paper towel goes, that's where I keep all the small stuff, and back here is, you know, receiving blankets and the pump and all that fun stuff, bigger items back here. So, now I'm going to show you what I keep in there. First, I always keep a hair clip in case I forget in the middle of the night to put my hair up. It's just nice to have it out of the way when I'm trying to feed her at like 4. I can barely see what I'm doing as it is, so I just need my hair out of the way. I feed her in bed, so it would definitely be easier if I just got up and came and fed her in the glider, but that's just not happening at 4 a.m., so... I also keep a pacifier in there. This thing never works. She never takes it, but just in the hopes that one of those days when she's really, really fussy, she'll take it. I keep it by the nightstand. So that goes in there too, but it's never used. So we didn't do a lot of breastfeeding the first 2 weeks. She ate a lot from a bottle. I would pump and feed her from a bottle. So it was really important that we find a bottle that had a nipple that looked kind of like a breast. So we got this. It's from the first years. It's called their Breast Flow bottle. Let me hold it up. This is what the nipple looks like. It's a three-part system. So let me just take it apart here real quick. No, this is the bottom. Very small. It's a, oh goodness, 5 ounce. I think it also comes in a 9 ounce, maybe 8 ounce. I got this at Target. So the first part is just, you know, the basic ring, whatever. It's the same with like every bottle. But this is where it is interesting. So the nipple is two parts, and they fit inside each other. You've got the clear part, which is the outside, and the blue part on the inside. This is where the milk goes into, inside the blue. And sometimes the milk pours, and you know, it just fits right in here. And sometimes the milk gets trapped between the clear and the blue. Basically what this is she has to compress not only the outside, but all the way into the inside. So it really makes her work harder, and it kind of stimulates breastfeeding a little more than your average nipple. So really, really like this. And you know, she doesn't have an issue with nipple confusion. She was given a bottle before she even breastfed, so, and she was able to go back and forth pretty easily. She doesn't get a lot of bottles now, but with me going back to work, she will be. So I'll probably invest in a couple more of these, probably in the larger size, but I really, really like this bottle, the first year's Breast Flow bottle. So I think it's $5.50. We bought ours at Target. Okay, so that's a bottle. Then we got the nipple cream. I swear I've never spent so much on my nipples. Okay, so we have the Lancinot cream. I have talked about this before. It's a lanolin cream. It will stain your clothing, so make sure you use it with breast pads. And since you apply it with your fingers, make sure you either wipe your fingers off on your breast pads or you have a rag nearby. Really like this, however, it is really thick, and sometimes it does hurt your newly broken in nipples. I mean, it's so thick that it really does moisturize and comfort them, but it kind of sometimes it hurts when you're applying it. So it kind of melts between your fingers with your body heat, but it did kind of hurt this first couple days. So I love it, but it wasn't the best. I love it now. Nowadays, I use this all the time. If I could go back, what I would have bought first is Earth Mama Angel Baby Natural Nipple Butter. It's in a little thing like this. This is lanolin free, and it melts onto my finger. I mean, it's just very thin and oily. The weird thing is that it's got these little, let's see, it's got these little like balls that look like tapioca balls in it. And they're kind of hard. They don't feel that great when you're rubbing it on your nipple, but they're in there for a reason. I have no idea what they are, but whatever. I really, really like this. If I could have gone back, I would have been using this from day one on. You know, they each have their place. They're both good, but whatever. Just so you know, the Lancinot cream might be a little rough on your nipples the first couple days. Some people have suggested, I think, the Medela nipple cream. I haven't used it because I have those two and they both work and I don't want to spend more money on my nipples. So, yeah. You okay over here? You okay? Getting cranky. Okay, so let's see. Then we're going to talk about nipple shields. This is all your fault, Missy. Nipple shields and shells. So first, I have my contact nipple shield. See, it's got kind of a weird shape. Oh, I don't know if you can't see. It's notched out here at the top, and that's where her nose goes, so that her nose touches your breast and not this plastic film. And this was really helpful in the first couple days because my nipples, well, they're not inverted, they were kind of flat. I guess they just weren't as long. I don't know. And so by using those nipple shields, what it did was the shield stimulates the back of her soft palate to suck. And so when she would suck, my whole nipple would fill the shell, and so she helped draw my nipple out. Nowadays, it's not a big deal, but those first couple weeks, it not only gave a barrier between her and me and my chapped nipples, but it also helped her latch. So those are definitely worth the investment. I really, really liked mine. I had two, actually, so. And I think it's important to have two because if not only you rely on them, but she relies on them, they're these small, completely see through invisible things. These are so easy to lose. So I would suggest having two of them so that in case if you lose one, you're not going to have a horrible feeding. So consider having two. Yes. Next thing is the nipple shells. Let me show them to you real quick and then I can hold her better while I'm talking about them. Oh. First of all, they're very hard plastic. They are, see, totally domed on the front, perfectly round. They've got these ventilation holes up on the top. And on the back, you either have a small hole or you have a big hole. You've got two back options. Oh, we gotta take these off, do it side by side. Big hole, small hole. Okay. Come here, you. All right, so the big hole you use if your nipples are just sore and they need a break. And basically what it does is you put your nipple through the big hole and it gets to kind of hang out in that free space between the back and the domed front. And so it doesn't rub against your clothing. It's not being compressed down. It gets some airflow. They're really, really great. The small back is used to help draw out your nipples if you have flat or inverted nipples. Now, I use these for multiple reasons. One, I was retaining so much fluid in those first couple days postpartum, even after my milk came in, it was really hard for her to even try to latch on, even with the breast shield, because my breasts retained so much water that everything was just like bloated. Even like my areola was like swollen. It was just so weird. So, yes, I used them then to kind of create an indentation so that my nipples stuck out a little bit more. And once my nipples became like cracked and sore and the most painful part of my body, I used them to kind of give them a break. The one bad thing is that those first couple days, your breasts are leaking like crazy, at least mine were. And so I would have this in my bra and I would be filling up with milk and then I would lean forward to pick something up and the milk would spill out of these little holes and I'd have all these little wet dots on my shirt from where milk was spilling out. So yeah, but if I was smart about it and I caught it, I could catch, you know, I don't know, a quarter ounce of milk, which at the time that was like half her feeding. So they're good and bad. I haven't used them at all since she was probably 2 weeks old, but those first 2 weeks I used them all the time. So I don't know. That is something that I would like borrow from a friend or give to a friend because they're so easy to sanitize, but that's just me. Okay, so now breast pads. I showed you guys the Johnson & Johnson contoured pads that I absolutely love. I use them day to day, but I wanted to show you guys some other ones. So I think these are the Lansinel. These are great and I like these because they come in an individual bag. And you just open up the bag, take them out, and they are folded in half. They've got an adhesive tape on both sides. And when you open them, you'll see that they are domed a little bit. But, you know, they're still kind of just huge. They're really big. The thing is, I use these, I keep these in my diaper bag, and I will start to carry them in my work bag. Because they're individually sealed, they're so hygienic. Whereas the Johnson & Johnson, they don't have a bag or anything like that. So those are great just right out of the box, but I wouldn't keep them in my diaper bag because they'd get all gross. So these are great for diaper bag. Not my favorite day-to-day at all. Yes. So then we have Soothies. My hospital gave me these. You can buy them at Target. They're super expensive. I think they're like between 10 and 12 bucks for one pair, which is like highway robbery. Basically what they are is they are super flat, perfectly round pads, and they are kind of a gauze on one side and a gel on the other, and you put the round gel disc right up against your nipple. It's this amazing cooling sensation. You can use them for like 72 hours or until they get completely saturated. I was leaking like crazy when I used these, and I was able to use them for the full 3 days without them saturating and getting all gross. They are so refreshing and cooling. They're wonderful. I love them. Thankfully, my hospital gave me a couple pair, and so I didn't have to buy them in the store. But they're worth it. If your hospital doesn't carry them, it doesn't have them, ask your lactation consultant. Then do buy them at the store because they're amazing. I love them. And you wouldn't think you'd want like ice right on your nipples or anything, like something that cold, but it's so amazingly soothing. So I like that. This is a newer purchase. They're Lily Pads. They come in this little plastic case. You can kind of see them. They are round, scallopy, contoured pads. They have a nice dome to them. And basically, you just put them... Okay, this is how you put them on. Hold on. We're showing people here. I love you. So the one side is sticky, one side is not. There's not like a glue or anything on there. I mean, you can wash these off and towel dry them, and they're still sticky on one side. Oh, I'm so sorry. And basically what you do is you flip it so that the sticky side is on the outside. You press it right up against your nipple, and then you smush it onto your boob so that it creates a suction cup. Hi. And since it like suctions to your breast, you don't leak. The only time it doesn't work for me is if I wear them overnight. That 4 a.m. feeding while I'm feeding her. Shum, ha-shum, ha-shum. The other side is so full that it will definitely just like bust right through the lily pad and I'll be leaking everywhere. Yeah, right. So that's the only time. Yeah. That's the only time they're not that great. But I like wearing them if I'm going to be out and about. I don't have to worry about leaking. Not that I really worry about leaking with the Johnson's pads, but they also have kind of a cooling sensation when you put them on. So I don't know. I like them. And the great thing is that they're reusable, so you're saving money that way. One thing I don't like about them is that they're not breathable. You know, they're suctioned right onto your boob. So I feel like if I wear them for like 4 hours or so, I need to like give my nipples a break and put on like some cotton breast pad and kind of give them some air. So anyway. Oh my goodness, this is a long video. Last but not least, I'm going to tell you guys about my pump. So I don't know how many of you are familiar with the Freestyle by Medela, but I'm assuming that it's not a lot. Let's show them your breast pump. Let's show him your pump. She likes it. Okay, so this is what the pump looks like. This is it. Boop, boop, boop. That's it. Fits in my hand. Hi. From the top here, you've got your tubing coming out. And the tubing comes out here. It's a double pump, so you can hook up one of these over here as well. If you want to just do a single pump, like in the middle of the night, she's nursed on one side, you have another side to nurse out, you just stick it in this middle. Hey! Hey! I know. You stick it in here. You bounce. Why are you being fussy? It's almost 9 o'clock. That's why you're fussy. She gets fussy at 9 o'clock. Come here. Ooh. So you push the on button. And it starts, I don't know if you can hear it, it starts a 2-minute letdown. If you let down sooner than that, you can just push this button. And it changes the sucking. And there's a plus and minus up here. If you push the plus, you increase the level. My nipples hurt just hearing that. And you can save your settings if you, you know, if you want to let down and then start at level 6 or whatever. You can save that in there. I don't save it. I just push the buttons. So that's my fancy Fancy, fancy. So, that's my 6-week breastfeeding update. I've totally run out of time. Sorry this was so long, but I hope it helps you guys. Have a great one. Bye, guys.